Dear Dylan, I read in the news about the trouble at your company, and I know this must be a tough time for you. Please don't hate me more than you already do for writing this.
Hey, man, how's it going?
Oh, how'd
right. Things go with the police?
Oh, not great. You look like you just ran a marathon.
Yeah, well, little Bill saw a friend of mine out in reception. By the time I got out there, she'd already left, so I thought maybe I could catch her on the sidewalk. I was too late, though.
Well, if she's worth chasing, better luck next time.
Thanks. Oh, man.
Hey, Marina. You got the room all to yourself. Don't you worry. We're going to get your mama back.
Mrs. Thorpe, what are you doing here?
Oh, Lucy. Actually, I've got a doctor's appointment.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing, I hope. In fact, I'm praying that all will be well. See you later. Yeah.
Dad, I got your baby. News. Sorry. The police found the van that Eleni was driving in. So how Michael and Frank were down there now.
License plate is the van. Bud's rented.
Look, we don't know what's in there. Now you could scare him into shooting your wife. Now that you gotta take him by surprise.
Oh, agree. All right. Look, that's the car. It's right.
Then fine. Whatever we do, let's just do it fast.
All right. Look.
Each of you take a door. When I give you the signal, you open the door.
Emily swore she'd never go back to Royce.
Never.
But what if her feelings still burn? What if she can't let go? Can she ever really forgive? Can she ever really forget?
Never say never.
Especially this week, as the world turns.
There you go, Lillian. And the specials are inside.
Thank you, Judith.
Get it out of your way.
I just heard about Eleni at the hospital. I just can't believe this.
Yeah, it's really terrible.
Frank must be, he must just be going crazy, huh?
Yeah, he is. Well, all I know is that he and everybody else are out looking for her, and I'm kind of manning the fort here till she gets home safe.
Oh, that's so nice of you.
Well, it's the least I can do. And it feels nice to have friends who need me, you know?
Oh, I do know. I mean, one of the best things about being a nurse is that when your own life is a mess, you can at least help other people.
Yeah. I'll be back to take your order, okay?
Okay, let's see. First, you have to be a citizen, and you have to be between the ages of 21 and 29 years old.
So far, so good, then.
And you can't have been convicted of a crime. Okay, you weren't. Weight.
What?
Okay.
Oh.
Height. All right. Uh-oh.
What?
No, it just says right here that you have to take a psychological test.
And you think that's where I'm going to fall on my face, right?
I don't know, David.
What do you mean you don't know?
Just kidding.
Look, I'm trying to be serious here, Kat. I'm filling out an application.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Thank
Go
you.
Right ahead. Let's see here. Things you should know if you're considering a career in law enforcement. You'll be rotating among three tours of duty, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., 4 to midnight, and midnight to 8. Boy, it looks like I'm going to have to go to night school if I plan on having any time with you.
The shifts, they're going to be a drawback.
Okay, well, wait a minute. Here's another one. The command voice.
And what is that?
It's the tone that cops are taught to use in potential explosive situations. They tend to take it home to their families.
You mean like,
get up against that wall and get your hands up in the air, honey.
Promise I'll never say anything like that to you, Kat.
I'm very happy to hear that, David. Are you sure that you're ready for all of this, though?
Kat, cops don't just push people around. They protect people, too. And anyway, I won't know for sure until I give it a shot, right?
Yeah. Your mother's not going to believe this, though.
Silly, can I talk to you for a minute?
What do you want?
Look, I know we're not each other's favorite people.
I'm busy, Bridget.
Okay, I'll go to the chase. When Hart left town, he left me his mayor, and she's sick. So I need to get a hold of him, and, I was wondering if you heard from him.
Bridget, if I had heard from Hart, you would be the last person I would tell.
Lady, where are you? I can't find anything around the van.
Great. Hey, well, stay put. Wait, I don't want anything touched until the forensics people get here.
Look, I know you're new on the police force, all right? But I am a professional detective, and I know not to mess around with evidence.
Look, sorry, we're gonna do this my way.
Yeah, well, your way's been a little too late.
Oh, Frank, will you cool it?
Alan Michael, you are not married to Lainey anymore, so stop pretending that you're her husband. The only reason that you're here is hopefully you can put an ID on this cycle that's kidnapped her. So don't you forget that.
No, I don't forget it for a minute, Frank, but I'm also not gonna forget the fact that she might still be okay if you guys hadn't been so cagey about where Bess Lowell is. Knock it off!
With a little luck, we're gonna be able to lift some prints. What are you talking about? This is a rental van. It's probably got hundreds of prints on it. It'll take days to sort through that, and we don't have days.
I know that. Now, look, you're just gonna have to know that I'm doing everything I can.
Let me tell you something. The person has a lady better be taking real good care of her, because I'll kill them.
Yeah, if they still have her. Okay, look, we know that they started out with the van, but the one thing that we're not for certain is that whoever grabbed Delaney, the storage place, drove her off in it.
What is it? It's Delaney's wedding ring. She was in there.
Your wife's a smart woman, then. She left it there on purpose to show us that she's still alive.
What is it?
Looks like blood.
Oh, no. What's happened to her?
Come on, lift your foot.
Is this? It's the first deserted spot I could find, some ancient health spa.
Yes, I think it said on the door that this place was condemned.
Oh, yeah? What a coincidence. So are you, unless you tell me how to find Bess Lowell. Or that Spalding contract. Your choice. Lie down.
I've told you over and over again I know nothing about a contract. And I do not know where Bess Lowell is. She was supposed to meet me at the storage place.
I'm so sick of that story. I'm sure you've got another one.
No, it is the only story I have because it is the truth.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Then I'm not like as many. What are you going to do to me? Ow!
What every woman hates the most. Make you exercise. A lot.
What are you doing? What?
It doesn't matter whether the tape we gave the cops is phony or whether it was planted. They have enough evidence against our hotshot investor to put him away for life and to freeze all his assets.
That's really incredible.
Josh, I'm making a promise to myself and to the family to get Lewis Construction out of this mess intact or damn near close to it.
I believe you, Dylan. But you know, you gotta stop being so hard on yourself. This kind of thing could happen to anybody.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. But I should have taken a closer look at this guy.
That's the problem with investors, though. A good credit rating can cover a multitude of sins.
The first lesson HB and Billy taught me was never let your guard down in business. I just haven't figured out how I'm supposed to cover all the bases when my personal life is falling apart at the same time. Do you know Eleni Cooper? She may have been Eleni Spaulding back then.
No, I don't.
Well, she's missing. They think she might be kidnapped.
What?
Now, here's her husband. Decent guy, trying to make a small family business run. And this terrible thing happens. And my question is, how's the guy supposed to think about the bottom line when he could lose his wife?
Dylan, look, the first lesson in life is you're only human. You look terrible, man. You look like you need some rest. Why don't you go home, get some sleep. I'll hold down the fort. I think most of the action is done for the day anyway. Go.
Depending on who shows up.
Go! Get out of here before I change my mind.
All right, thanks, Josh.
Out of here.
I've started so many letters to you and thrown them all away, but I guess I need you to know how I feel. I know how much I hurt you. I know you may never forgive me. But it would be a terrible waste not to tell you that if you ever need a friend, I'm here for you. A friend and a meal, too. Anytime you could use either, just stop by the diner and be my guest.
Exactly told you about the van.
That new detective down at the police station.
What did they tell you exactly?
They told me what I told you. That they found Eleni's van. I think his exact words were, we found Mrs. Cooper's van.
And then what happened?
And then Al, Michael, and Frank went down there, and I hightailed down here as fast as I could to tell you.
Did they say anything about finding Eleni? Did they say anything about Eleni?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. My gosh, if I'd known I was going to get the third degree, I wouldn't have come down here. I'd have waited. I thought you wanted to know. I guess I was wrong. I can't seem to do anything right around here.
Honey, I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm sorry. Okay, look. Just this whole rotten situation. The idea of losing somebody this way that you love. I gotta tell you, there were times between when you were in Santa Fe, between the time that you'd go to the bank and Gomez would report to me, and I had nightmares about this kind of thing happening to you.
Yeah, well, you didn't have to. I never got close enough to high finance for anybody to need to come to me to find out anything.
Well, you had to come here and get involved with the Thorpes and the Spaulding's to find real danger.
Mr. Cooper,
yeah?
There's a phone call for you.
Thanks. Yeah. Frank, did you find her?
No, the van was empty.
And we found her wedding ring in the back. And there was blood in there.
Frank, it may not be hers. Any idea where they took her?
No.
Where are you now?
I'm at the firehouse, but I really want to come over and see my daughter.
No, she's... Hey, look, she's fine. She just eaten. She'll be sleeping like an angel pretty soon. Look, Frank, it is important that you stay at the firehouse with Bess. You got to guard her with your life. She's the key. She's what they're after. Do you hear me?
Dr. Sedgwick, are you absolutely certain that I am pregnant?
There's no doubt about it. Congratulations, Mrs. Thorpe. It's what you said you were hoping for.
Oh, yes.
Now, there are a few more routine tests I want to run before you leave.
Alan Michael thinks the woman who has Eleni could be one of Roger Thorpe's old pals from intelligence.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, but
that's not easy to check out, though. You know, there's got to be a way to find out who she is.
Well, actually, it might be a good time for me to go nosing around on that subject.
Where?
You just stay put, okay? And Frank?
Yeah?
We're gonna get her back. I feel it in my bones. I gotta go somewhere.
Where?
A little fact-finding mission. You stay here with her.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, little Marina.
Oh.
You're my niece.
Guess that makes me an aunt.
Thank you.
missed you too.
My father says I have to stay here and guard you, but I'd rather be out there looking for my wife.
Eleni and that plunger must be on foot by now, Frank, and that'll slow them down, so the police don't
The police are searching a 30-mile radius from where the van was found. But that's going to take about a week. Meanwhile, the lady who tore apart that storage room is probably tearing apart my wife right now looking for that document in which she knows nothing about.
But that's a good thing, Frank. That could be her salvation that she doesn't know.
I'll be her salvation. Right now, you're going to tell me where that document is, because I'm going to go out and get it right now because I want my wife back.
We'll continue with part two of Guiding Light in a moment.
David, I'm just thinking about you arresting some poor criminal, slapping some handcuffs on him, and then reading him his rights. I just can't see. I can't see it.
Look, what if it's a guy who's twice my size, Kat? He's packing a rod. It's gonna be me who's trembling in my boots.
Right, and me who's going crazy just at the thought of it.
Do you think it would scare you to the point where you couldn't live with it?
David, I would never stop you from doing something that you really wanted to do.
You had a pretty strong reaction to the idea when I first mentioned it.
Well, yeah, that's because I was just a little bit concerned as to why you chose to take your life in this direction.
Hey, it came as a surprise to me, too.
What appeals to you about it?
I think the opposites. You know, action and adventure and... You don't know what's coming next, but there's security, too. And you get to protect decent people from the bad ones who prey on them.
That's if the system allows you to do that.
If it doesn't, we have to change the system.
Well, that's easier said than done. Have you told your parents?
There's nothing to tell, Kat. I'm just filling out an application.
Yeah, well, I can't wait to see your mother's face when she finds out you'll be wearing a blue collar instead of a white one.
Look at it this way. It's better than a prison uniform. And when I'm on the streets after midnight, this way she'll know why.
Yes, but cops have to deal with criminals all the time, and I'm sure that's not the element of people your mother would like to go bragging to her bridge club about.
Well, we can't always please our mother's bridge clubs, can we?
You're absolutely right. What about Jilly? Have you told her that you might be a cop?
I don't think Jilly's gonna have a problem with it, but I get the distinct impression you do.
What have you got against some poor sick animal?
Absolutely nothing. I suggest you call a vet.
I think I should get a hold of Hart in case there's something he wants to do about it.
Like what? Come back? Stop dreaming, Bridget.
You don't know anything about my dreams, Jill.
Everybody knows about your dreams. You've been talking about it ever since you first set eyes on Hart, and you just never give up.
You know, you talk about him like he's your personal property. I hate to tell you, he hasn't been for a while.
Yeah, well, if I were you, I should be a little concerned that if he comes back, the same thing will happen that happened before. He'll come back for me.
Actually, I'm quite frankly not worried about that at all.
Well, then why are you so sure that he's going to get in touch with me before you?
I'm not so sure about that. I just thought I'd ask. You know, after everything that's happened, you still have to have a man at the end of your chain, don't you? I mean, haven't you learned anything?
Yeah, I've learned a lot.
You were so selfish, you don't even want Hart to have a life if it doesn't include you.
Yeah, right. That's why I'm here at the diner. That's why I'm taking care of Marina until Eleni gets back, because I'm so much more selfish than you are. And what is a noble reason that you're looking for Hart? Oh, something about his horse.
Shut up, Julie.
You just don't get it, Bridget. Nobody who has loved me will ever look at you with anything but pity. Dylan.
What'd you just say to her, Julie?
I know how much you miss her, honey. But I got a little secret. I got a feeling that she's thinking about you right now, and she's missing you just as much. She's fighting her way to get back to you. Oh, Marina, if there was any way that your mommy could be here to... hold you in her arms close to her, I know that she would be. She's gonna find her way back here because she wants to be with you every day. She wants to greet you in the morning. Yeah, she wants to greet you in the morning. She wants to put you to bed at night. supposed to know what that felt. But Uncle Al Michael was foolish. He lost it. But you never will. No matter what you do, no matter how many mistakes you make, you're gonna have her love forever. I wanted you to be mine so badly. Hers and mine. This wasn't meant to be. Hey, you. The next best thing that I can do is bring your mommy back to you. And that's what I'm gonna do, Marina. I swear it.
I can help Al Michael. I know where Bethel is.
That contract is our insurance lottery. Leverage. That's the only leverage we have to keep them from hurting her.
I don't intend on giving it to them until I get Lainey back safe.
Oh, there's too much risk, don't you see? Something could go flat. I'll tell you where it is. They follow you. They take the document. They hurt you. Then Elaney's life is worth nothing to them.
You don't care about Elaney. You just care about yourself. You don't give a damn about Elaney.
No, that's not true. I love her.
No, you know, she doesn't need that kind of love. Think about it, Bess. What happens if you have another stroke?
What?
What happens if you die? No one will ever be able to find that contract. And then what happens to Lainey?
Well, I have no intention of dying. I'm going to outlive those skunks.
Yeah, you know what? If you don't tell me where it is, you'll outlive Lainey.
Don't, Frank, don't. Look, I swing to you on my beloved mother's soul. I am holding out, not for the highest bidder. I'm holding out for Lainey's sake.
You know, I promised her a really good life. I promised her that I would protect her. And our home and our child. She trusted me, but I haven't been able to protect her from anything. I love her more than anything in the whole world, and I have failed her.
Lainey doesn't think that. She basks in your love. She's the happiest woman I've ever known.
How can I just sit here, though, and do nothing? I mean, think about it. Think what she must be going through right now.
Oh, yes. 25 pounds here. 25 pounds.
How's that? Is there a difference? Lots of weights around here, hundreds of pounds. How many do you think you can hold up with those skinny little arms?
Oh.
Will they collapse and let the bar fall on your neck?
You can put as many weights as you want on here, and I still do not know anything.
I believe you, Lainey. It's just that I'm counting on the fear of strangling to death to improve your memory. 100 pounds or so from now, you may have a sudden revelation. I've seen it happen. Often. You know, these walls around here are very thick, so if you get an impulse to scream, go ahead. You won't disturb anybody. What is it they say in gym speak? No pain, no gain?
What kind of woman are you?
A new breed. Anything a man can do, I can do worse and make it hurt more. You ready for the next level?
I do not know about any contract. Bess did not tell me about any contract.
I hate amateurs. You don't understand how you... to be stubborn.
You call yourself a professional? Your boss would not want you treating me like this.
What makes you think I have a boss?
Why would you want this contract for yourself?
Don't ask me any questions. You're gonna need your strength.
Oh, no more. No more.
Dad,
I said that I would support you 100% in whatever it is that you decide to do, but if you get accepted into the police academy, are you going to quit your job here?
Well, I couldn't afford to right off. I mean, he hasn't been asking me for it, but I'm determined to pay Ross Mahler back as much as I can for my defense in the hearing.
I'm glad.
So I guess I'll have to handle both gigs for a while.
I guess I'll see you in a couple of years when we're old and gray, huh?
Okay. The only reason I'm spending more time here now than I have to is because of what's going down with the Coopers. But as soon as we know that Elaney's okay, every minute that I have free belongs to you.
Believe me, Dylan, you do not want to know what we were arguing about. It's just the same old stuff. Anyway, I'm glad to see you. You got my note?
Yeah, it was nice.
Excuse me, I think you should tell him what you just said to me.
Lighten up, Bridget.
Then why don't both of you give it a rest?
I totally agree with you. Look, I just wanted to let you know that I'm really sorry to hear about the trouble at work. How did this all this happen?
Somebody wanted to get even with me.
For what?
For something I did to somebody to get even with them.
Boy, your business sounds pretty cutthroat.
Yeah, but the kicker is it was all for nothing, really.
Well, I guess revenge really isn't that sweet after all.
Guess not.
Well, listen, if you want to take a booth, I'd be happy to make you that dinner, I promise.
Wait a minute here. Before we get too cozy, I think you should answer my question about Hart.
Bridget came by to see if I had heard from Hart. I told her that I hadn't.
Oh, no. I believe what you said was you wouldn't tell me if you had. And the only reason I kept pressuring you was because, you know, I mean, last week when you heard he had left town, you just couldn't stop talking about it.
You are so ridiculous. Would you like to take a table?
Look, Julie, the reason I came here was because your letter hit me in the right place at the right time. The idea of maybe being able to be friends. But when you come right down to it, I think we're still a long way off from that.
Well, you still want to have something to eat?
No. I think I better go somewhere else tonight. But thanks anyway. So long, Bridget.
Bye, Dylan. Take care, okay?
Look here, the results of your tests. Everything is normal. Yes, and you are in excellent health. Now, you may feel a little sleepier than usual at first, but just go with it. You can eat normally. Just try and go a little light on the salt. Mrs. Thorpe, are you all right? It's just, well, you seem a little uncertain. Are you having second thoughts?
Oh, no. No, I'm not. I've dreamed so often of having my first child. It's just I didn't dream it would be this way.
What way is that?
Oh, I'm just rambling. I think I'm so excited and overwhelmed all at the same time. I'm not making any sense, am I? Dr. Sedgwick, could I ask you a question, please?
Mm-hmm.
It's very important. Please, don't tell anyone of this news, especially my husband.
Oh, certainly. I'll see you at your next appointment. But don't forget, if you have any questions of any kind, call me.
I will.
someplace, huh? Picture, phone number, so.
Okay, Thorpe. Come on, what do I do with her now? Come on, answer. Answer, Mr. Big.
Carlos, I'm telling you, Lewis Oil is standing behind Lewis Construction. You just have to... Listen to me, please. Just be patient. Give us a little time. Not long, I promise. Just let us figure out where we stand, all right? Thank you. I appreciate it. You will hear from us soon. Goodbye. Ah! Probably on a plane already, on her way to the Bahamas or Istanbul. Someplace like that.
Enough yet?
Have you?
Me? I'm not the one pressing. How many pounds are we up to here?
You have no children, do you?
Oh, I don't discuss my personal life with strangers.
Your boss would not want you doing this to me. I have a child. You'd be in big trouble.
Okay. We've exercised this muscle group long enough. Okay, get up.
Come on.
Hurry up. Hurry up. Do those straps, strap yourself in. Strap yourself in. I grab this bar. Ow? Am I hurting you?
The other.
I want you to run back and tell people I chafed your skin.
Why are you in such a hurry, huh?
With your encouragement, I came up with a much better way to get you to tell me what I want to know. Much more efficient. In fact, I really should have thought of this before, but I let your delicate looks fool me. You're much tougher than you look.
What are you talking about?
Using a different kind of pain.
Pain? What do you mean by different kind? Where are you going?
I can't do anything because you won't tell me where that document is. And you know Eleni's life is in danger.
The police can...
But I am her husband. I am the only one that should have the right to negotiate her release.
Yes, but she wouldn't want anything to happen to you.
It wouldn't, because it's too important.
Damn, I don't know how to make a decision anymore. I don't even know what the Stark thing is to do.
I'll tell you what to do. I could bring her home if you help me. She'd be able to see Marina again. She'd be able to see all of us, and you would get to see her again.
Maybe I should...
Michael.
Who is it? Who is it?
Alan Michael Frank with Lucy. Come on, let me in.
Michael. What are you doing here? How did you find us?
I overheard Buzz on the phone.
How did you do something so stupid like that? He was one of the ones that we're trying to hide her from. I was just about to find out where she put the document.
Wait a second. Document? What do you mean, what document?
There's no document. It's nothing.
No, obviously it's something, Frank. You know, Bess, the last time I ran into you, you were suffering from selective amnesia.
You know for that.
This is no game, Bess. Was there another legal paper that I didn't lose?
Bess, you do not have to tell
shut
me
up,
anything.
Frank.
Don't you tell me to shut up.
The pipe is out of the bag. I'm well aware it's no game. You never asked me for all the copies of the Spalding contract.
I don't believe this. Fantastic. You had another copy.
What the hell do you think they're looking for? And Lena doesn't have any idea about it. I'm going to tell you exactly what I'm going to do. The second I get my hands on that thing, I am going to trade that document for her release, and it's probably going to end up in Roger Thorpe's fireplace.
Fine, you do whatever you have to do to get Eleni. Eleni's safe.
Oh, you're really a piece of work, Alan Michael. The only reason you wanted to find Bess is so you can get your damn company back.
Yeah, well, that was before Eleni was taken, Frank.
Oh, you mean to tell me you don't care about Spalding anymore? I find that very hard to...
I care about Spalding, Frank, but if that's the only way we're going to get Eleni back, then I say, fine, we use the paper.
Not us, Alan Michael. Me. I'm going to tell you something else, too. I don't want you to do any more of your stupid schemes. I can get her hurt.
You are going to need more help than you know.
Both of you, plug up. And then I'll tell you where the Spalding contract is.
Some changeling that got dropped into the clan when nobody was looking. You really would give up the family business that's been built over three aberrations for the sake of one simple woman? Doesn't even love you anymore? The boot?
Yes, I would.
What could have inspired that kind of passion in a man? My life would have been more interesting. That's over. Split rocks. So, all right. The Spalding contract is with Eleni's baby. It's sewed up in Marina's little lab.
Provided by Founds.
You've been kidnapped and tied up by a dangerous woman. What would push you to fight back? Eleni gets a hard shove tomorrow on Guiding Light.